Wait, what's that? Where's that coming from?
Hell yeah.
What is that?
Oh, here it comes.
All right.
How do we set
here?
This
Hold
up?
On. No one told you that was gonna be this way. Your job's a joke, you broke. Your love life's the away. It's like you're always stuck in second gear. When it hasn't been your day, your week, your month, or even your year, I'll be there for you.
Must-see TV Thursday nights.
Yeah, baby.
From Friends. The year 1994 to 2004, Friends.
Why do I know that that was the Rembrandts?
Because it's the theme song to Friends, which was one of the greatest TV shows of our
our
adolescence, our upbringing. Must-see TV. I mean, I remember people, it was, I don't know how else you say it. It was must-see TV.
Was it on the same level?
And Josh, do not come across me. Do not dive across this board at me. Was it on the same level as a Seinfeld?
I'm sorry.
100%.
I'm sorry. I think you said something in my bad ear. I know it was on the same night, wasn't it, as Seinfeld? Doesn't really matter, but I think that was part of must-see TV Thursday.
In the pantheon of, like, major American shows, I got to say, Seinfeld and Friends were 1 and 1A. I mean, depending on which part of the population you talk to, I think there was plenty of overlap in audiences. If you like Seinfeld, you like Friends, you like Seinfeld. And, I mean, Phoebe, Ross, Joey, Monica, Chandler, Rachel. I can still name all the cast members of the show.
Yes.
And Mike said in a meeting that Friends is what, Michael?
I thought it was a girl show. And this came up because over the weekend...
I thought we were in 2018.
I thought this was a woke...
We're dialing it back to 1994 through 2000.
Oh, okay. A show targeted at women, okay?
Where the world wasn't as woke and there were shows that... All right, yeah, let's just stop, okay? Some shows are targeted towards women. Some are targeted towards men. Mike thought this skewed female.
Yeah, so I'm talking to Brett Hollander on WBAL 1090.
Noted female.
1-4. And he had texted me, I was a huge fan of Friends when I was younger, and I'm not ashamed to say that.
Neither am I.
And then I thought, you know, this might be a good topic because I always thought that this was a girl show, but I know there's a lot of guys out
and
there
you
that
watched
like it.
It as well, but you were afraid to say you were
no
afraid.
No, I never got into it. My sister was a huge fan. Really? Had all the DVDs, but I like I said, I always thought
so
that this
you
was
really
for women.
Don't have a leg to stand on given that you've never really even seen it.
I mean, I've seen enough to know that it's not for me. I know that much.
Really? Wow.
I just could never get into it. And like I said, I thought it was targeted at women, so I felt uncomfortable even being a viewer.
Okay, the show Charmed, which I also watched because I am a lady on the WB, that was a very lady-centric show. All-female cast, a lot of up with women, a lot of women
sex
empowerment.
Sex in the City.
Female show. Okay, the A-Team, skewed male.
Yeah,
Cheers.
Not a big secret here,
skewed
right?
Skewed male. But I felt like Friends with, I mean, and quite literally numerically,
and 3-3.
Yes.
3 females, 3 males, right down the middle.
An even split. You had an even split of special guest stars. Winona Ryder, Bruce Willis, Reese Witherspoon, Paul Rudd. It seemed like it totally walked the line of just being for everyone.
And I think Mike had a little bit of a different experience with his... with Friends because it came out when he was still in high school. So come Friday morning, he would go to school and it would seem like, you know, all of the girls were talking about
it. They were obsessed.
And all
of
the guys, they were probably still watching it, but they didn't feel comfortable talking about it for whatever reason. So he was still inside that like high school bubble where that's your world. And when you go to school the next day and that's the zeitgeist, that's what everybody's talking about. And that kind of skews your perception of things. Whereas I was already out into the world and I was doing my own thing. So I didn't have that experience where you're just surrounded by people that are talking about this one thing and it maybe makes you go, oh, well, maybe is female or maybe this is a girl, you know, quote unquote girl show. Speaking of TV, we're talking old school sitcom Friends. It was on from 1994 to 2004. Remember, they were the first cast, I think, to ever reach the $1 million mark. Every single one of them, all six of them, they signed the same contract. They were all getting $1 million. Was it $1 million?
Yeah, $1 million an episode.
An episode.
Yeah, and didn't they, correct me if I'm wrong about this, I might be, how like the Jersey Shore did it, and we would love to, but damn our contracts. They all went in as an entity saying you pay all of us or you get none of us.
Yeah, that's leverage.
Yes, we botched that. They said, listen, you're going to pay each and every one of us, and if you don't, we're walking. Like, well, what choice do we have? Yeah, critical reception, pretty incredible. God, how many awards did they win? Did they win any?
The point is, Mike thinks it was during his experiencing of the airing of the show. Never watched it and thought it was a show that was geared towards women.
Yeah. Mike, let's also be honest. Went to a school with a bunch of people that drove their tractors with shotgun racks on them to school.
That's a very good point.
Okay.
But I mean, it was a pretty diverse school.
Yes. White, but tall white, short white, fat white, and hairy white.
Everything about... Well, I mean, and that's the other thing, too, about this show. I remember them getting flack for being an all-white cast. Remember that?
Yeah.
They got some...
That these days. Oh, they'll bounce that show off the air quick. Where's the Vietnamese girl in a wheelchair?
Yeah, very little diversity on Friends. But everything about the show just screamed feminine to me. I mean, even as far as like the logo, Friends, with all the colors on there. The intro, the intro song.
Have you never wanted to splash around
in a fountain? Splashing in a fountain, Mike. Who amongst us?
Come on.
All wearing the same monochrome outfits and jumping around on a couch and in the fountain. The whole thing just screamed that this was designed and manufactured for women to me. So I was surprised over the weekend when a male friend of mine said, it was one of his favorite shows. And I'm like, what?
I stand lockstep with that friend.
Yep. Loved it.
Loved it. Every single episode, every Thursday night, must watch TV.
1996, out back of the Costco, Waldorf, Maryland, where we used to skate at the loading docks, just a bunch of wayward youth. What were we doing? Smoking weed out of a soda can, trying to get our older friend, Ben Hurd, to buy us liquor. He was 22, working on heel flips, talking about Friends. The whole Waldorf skate scene worshipped Friends. We'd watch 401 skate video. We'd read Trans World magazine. We'd wait for a new World Industries video to come out, and then we would discuss the ongoing relationship between Chandler and Phoebe.
I mean, Jennifer Aniston's. It was always very cold in the apartment.
Yeah,
remember that?
Well, wasn't always there rumors that she used nipple implants?
Yes, her nipples were always on display.
Mike, for a bonus point, don't look. What was the name of the coffee house that they went to?
Oh, easy.
Oh, Mike, dude,
so easy.
Well, it's like name. What's the name of the bar in Cheers?
Cheers.
Cheers, yes. What's the name of the coffee shop?
Was it Java?
Central. Mm-hmm.
Perk. Central Perk. Yeah. Central Perk.
Okay, yeah, I remember that, barely.
There you go.
God, think of the guest stars. Some texts say, I always thought Friends was for girls as well. I never watched it growing up, but my ex-wife got me into it, and I love that show. I watch the reruns on Netflix daily.
Yeah, maybe
Friends is a very balanced show. There's tons of jokes commenting on both sexes. It was a great show. Hit the nail on the head on all fronts. And honestly, that's what it says, on all fronts.
Well, let's see what we got here. Let's talk to Sean in Kent Island. What say you about Friends? Girl show?
Definitely.
Really?
I only watched it because my wife watched it. That's it. That simple.
Did you enjoy it?
Nah.
Really?
Really? See, I loved it.
What were you watching instead? What tickled your fancy?
I don't even remember that time frame. I was too busy doing work.
Oh, wow.
He's a man.
He's out there splitting logs.
But yeah, that's the thing. It seemed to appeal to women far more than men. Like I said, women kind of took ownership of this show, at least in my world. It was their show. They talked about it.
I think that's your perception.
Yeah.
I said, because you went to high school every morning after that.
Yeah.
And it seemed like the girls were all talking about it and the guys wanted to, but they were afraid to for some reason.
Maybe. Because
I was already graduated high school. I was starting college and we were just living life. And you didn't have that, homeroom high school bubble experience. You were just free to do whatever the hell you wanted.
Yeah.
And experience things the way you want.
What say you, Sam, checking in from Pennsylvania? What's up, buddy?
Well, I'm going to say long-time listener, first-time caller.
Thank you, sir.
Shout out.
Mr. Spiegel, good morning. How are you?
Good morning.
Good form.
I'd like to say that I would also have to agree with Mr. Anderson on this one.
Really?
And I believe that me and Mr. Anderson also went to the same high school.
See?
Uh-huh.
It has something to do with it.
Okay.
It has something to do with it.
Turn this up, okay? Did you major in hay, wheat, or oats?
Actually, I drove my lawnmower to own the tractor to school.
I knew it. Oh, Mike, you grew up in a great part of the country. Why did you think
my
it was a
35? So.
Why did you think it was a female show?
I don't know. Just the guys just seemed a little feminine on there. It just,
yeah, I got one of those.
I don't know.
They said the dudes were very like metrosexual and. Which, I don't know, Joey was basically a caveman.
Yeah, he was a dumb cronk of a dude.
And Chandler was, you know, goofy.
Okay,
and
Ross was a drippy little
Ross
sissy.
Ross was a drippy sissy metrosexual.
But yeah, Matt LeBlanc, Joey, he was a dude's dude, dumb as hell, but a dude's dude, thank you. Let's see what we got here. Fred in Owings Mills disagrees. Fred, good morning.
Hey, good morning. I want to side with definitely more of a chick show lean for sure. And, yeah, I agree that the guys were a bit on the metro side. So in my humble opinion, chick show.
All right. Yeah. There it goes. God, let's go to Kelly in Baltimore County. Kelly, good morning.
Hi, good morning.
Hi.
Hello.
No, this was definitely a show for guys, too. I mean, there was all the hot girls on there. That's
Courtney
why my
Cox?
Guy friends watched it.
Just listen to her last name.
Courtney Cox, Jennifer Aniston, even what's-her-face, Lisa Kudrow,
who we hate.
Right.
Smelly Cat and all
exactly.
that.
Exactly.
Yeah, well, that's like, what we said. It was three guys.
My boyfriend
he
used to love watching Desperate Housewives, too, with me, because it was all the hot chicks.
Yeah, I mean, Friends was three guys and three girls right down the middle. It was perfect.
Yeah. Now, I get Desperate Housewives, Wisteria Lane, but that show was, like, drenched in murder and backstabbing and weird, like...
I loved that show.
Desperate Housewives
See?
Was an effing 10. The lady that kept her son chained up in the basement?
Oh, yeah.
That was
yeah.
creepy as hell. Yeah, it had a fresh coat of paint on the outside of it, but there was this underlying rot to the town.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that show was for just psychopaths, not even genders. Let's talk to. I watched it also, and I regularly take an antipsychotic. Let's go to Andrew in PA. Andrew, good morning.
Morning. Hey, all I have to say is, yeah, that's great. Geared a little bit towards females, but Jennifer Aniston was an absolute smoke show.
She was. Yeah. Back in the day, them nipples, that haircut.
Uh-huh. Baby hungry. Let's take one or two more and we'll bounce. Let's go to Baltimore Joe, our buddy. What's up, Joe?
Hey, guys. Hey, you.
Good morning, Josh.
Good morning.
All right. So I told Mike earlier, love him to death. He's a great guy and everything. Great producer. Pay him more money. But this is not a chick show. It reaches all around. And when it first came out, I was fairly young. And then during the early 2000s is when I was first started getting into it, and I watch all the reruns all the time myself, and it's a great show, and like all the other callers, you can't go wrong with the hot chicks on there, except Courtney Cox. She's kind of ugly.
What?
You're an idiot.
Bite your
She's the highest
You're bad.
One.
No, Baltimore Joe, no, you're banned from
Don't
the show.
You disparage
Don't you call in for a week.
Good
now you're banned. You got
name.
Stuff banned for a week.
Banned.
How dare you?
How dare you speak ill of that woman? How dare you? Know what just happened?
You know what? You're getting the ban hammer.
That's right. Mm-hmm.
You're never
banned.
Allowed to talk to me again or my friends. You're banned forever, okay?
Not forever.
You're banned.
Until tomorrow. There are lots of ways to listen to 98 Rock every day. 97.9 FM, streaming live on 98online.com. The 98 Rock smartphone app on iPhone and Android, and on your Amazon Alexa and Google Home. Make sure to follow us on Facebook at facebook.com/98online.